It was a scramble for parents all across the province today as all 83,000 elementary school teachers walked off the job and onto the picket lines for the union's first ever province-wide one-day strike.
If you have a child in a public elementary school, they're going to miss 2 days of classes this week due to strikes, and now next week as well.
Good evening and thanks for joining us. It is now official. Canada has its first confirmed case of the new strain of coronavirus. A man in...
The government has received the advice of Ontario's Chief Medical Officer of Health and the COVID-19 command table, recommending that the province close down all public elementary, middle and high schools for 2 weeks following March break. I've swiftly accepted that advice.
It is clear that we cannot open schools at this time. I'm just not going to risk it. This wasn't an easy decision to make, but it was the right decision. We've made the decision to put our kids' safety first. And at the same time, we have a plan to ensure that our children's education can continue outside of the classroom. At-home learning will continue.
You smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side when nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star and we came so far, and know they won't forget. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us, and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember, when you think back on all done, I hope you're proud when you look back and see how far we've come. It was our time to shine and nobody could hold us down. They thought they'd see us fall, but we stood so tall, and no, we won't forget.
Yeah. Welcome to this, your virtual graduation for the graduates of 2020. Today we celebrate the efforts and achievements of our class of 2020. This certainly has been an unusual and very unprecedented year. Despite the many challenges, hiccups, and roadblocks you've encountered, you've walked through and left a path behind which you can be proud of and celebrate. What makes Sir John Moore Community School so special is, I think, within our name itself. We are a community. Communities strive to support one another and to celebrate one another. So let's continue to do that. It's my pleasure and honor to welcome each of you to our virtual graduation of 2020. To our grads, you made it, and we're proud of you. Although your school year morphed into something very unusual, each of you have succeeded. And to our families, congratulations on supporting your children through elementary school and through this current situation. We at Sir John Moore appreciate you. It is often said that from unusual times and events, we learn what we are truly capable of being and capable of doing. In the words of Winnie the Pooh's best friend, Christopher Robin, you're stronger than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. Congratulations to the graduates of 2020. Graduates and families, please join me in recognizing the traditional land acknowledgement and the playing of our national anthem.
We acknowledge that the land on which we are gathered is part of the traditional territory of the Chippewa, Odawa, Potawatomi, and Delaware Nations.
I made a color-coded chart. It'll track your hourly progress for the next 4 weeks. Dude, get a paper towel.
We're out of paper towels.
Okay, we're gonna start the day by reading for an hour. Then I want you to come to me and give me a summary of what you've learned. Are you watching Love is Blind?
I'm learning that relationships are built on trust, and you can't learn this in school.
Okay, yeah, fine.
We are gonna make math fun. It's not mathematics, it's mathemagic. Watch as I make this coefficient disappear. How do you not understand PEMDAS? In my day, we split these up and did long division over here. Wait, this is wrong.
There may not be PE or team sports, but we're still gonna get exercise. Fine, TikTok dances are exercise.
Sure.
You guys are gonna do daily chores, okay? Could you guys just flush the toilet? Could that be a thing we do?
Hey, what are you gonna do while I edit for the next 4 hours?
I'm
want to get ahead of my studies.
What are you doing while I'm working?
Playing Xbox.
Okay.
I can't wait to make you a nutritious lunch every day. I mean, it's all about gut health, you know?
There's nothing but toilet paper in the pantry.
Toilet paper has fiber. Good for the gut. Keeps things moving. I worked hard for that toilet paper. I had to fight like 47 moms to get that roll. Enjoy.
Congratulations to this year's grade 8 class. You did it. You get to go to high school, and high school is so much fun, and we're all so proud of you. Good luck next year.
Hi, graduates. It's Mrs. J. I just wanted to tell you how proud I was of you and how I know you're going to do great things in the future. And I was just thinking today about our experiences together, like doing tie-dye shirts and going to Rock Glen and going bowling. And I just remember you as such a mature group and that you always tried to help each other. And I know that you're going to help each other in high school and be real leaders when you get there. Thanks, bye-bye.
Hi guys, Graham and Nancy. I'm so proud of you guys. I can't believe that you're graduating, going on to high school. It seems like yesterday that I was helping you all, doing crafts, and especially those hugs. Anyway, enjoy your next experiences in high school. I love you all. Bye.
Hello, graduates. As you embark on this next stage in your lives, I want you to remember, be kind to others. Boost each other up, whether it's supporting your friends by making them laugh or complimenting them to boost their self-esteem. Work hard. Take care of you and do what you love. Today is a day to be proud of all you have accomplished and learned thus far. Today is also a day to embrace what is to come, what will be learned, and what you will accomplish. I'm so proud of you. Congratulations.
To all of you SJM graduates of 2020, this has been a year to remember for sure. I know that for some of you, this has been a hard and, well, somewhat disappointing end to your elementary experience. But I challenge you to look at the positive. You can rest assured that this school year's end will be a part of human history that will be remembered, and you will have been a part of it too. So cherish it rather than abolish it, as it will be a story for you to tell for the rest of your life. You were a part of history. No other grade eights in years past can share this historical moment with you. Take it in. Now, I can say to you all good luck, but I'd rather you make your own luck. Instead, I will leave you with the words of the iconic Dr. Seuss. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. And you are the one who will decide where to go.
To the graduating class of 2020 at Sir John Moore, congratulations. You have graduated. And this year has been a challenging, unique, and all but bizarre school year that I don't think you will probably ever encounter again. Imagine the memories that you've just created. You guys have rose to the challenge. You were flexible. You were determined, and you finished off this year with grace. I am excited to see what you guys do in grade 9, and please remember that kindness is never wasted. Come back and visit us at Sir John Moore and let us know how you are doing. Lots of love to you guys, and remember, stay caffeinated.
Well, this has been an interesting year. I would like to take a minute to congratulate all of the graduates of the 2020 Sir John Moore class. You have all shown yourselves to be a great group of students who have accomplished great things during the last 10 years here that you've spent at our school. Moving forward, remember everything you have accomplished and trust in yourselves. If you have learned anything this year, it is that you are resilient, adaptive, and intelligent. It has been a pleasure to be a part of your journey, and I look forward to seeing all of you later on and hearing of all the adventures you have had. This year especially is important to me as I move on to new challenges and adventures as well. The only advice I will leave you with is that the only constant thing in life is change, and that nothing worthwhile comes easy. The things we value most in life come with a struggle. We find out who we truly are when we are presented with a situation or circumstance that may seem hopeless. It is in these moments we remember to get our lives together and persevere through. You are all strong and capable. We believe in you, and if you believe in yourself, you can accomplish wonders. Congratulations and good luck.
English is often taken for granted. We inherently speak it, read it, and engage each other through conversations without a second thought. Studying it, however, can sometimes be frustrating, repetitive, and disengaging, especially as an intermediate student. The recipient of the English Award genuinely found enjoyment in studying English. She has passionately read and engaged in numerous texts throughout the year, clearly and confidently demonstrated her writing in multiple styles, led conversations and shared thoughts and opinions with her classmates, and creatively utilized media available to her for presentations and research. She has also received the highest overall mark in all language strands. It is my pleasure to present this year's 2020 English Award to Jenna Munden. Congratulations, Jenna.
Tonight I have the honor to present the French Immersion Award. This award goes to the student who demonstrates an interest in the French language and has the highest overall average in the strands of listening, speaking, reading, and writing. Over the past year, this student has consistently demonstrated a passion for learning about language and culture. Even though this year has presented its challenges, this student has risen to the occasion by participating and thriving through all the obstacles we face today. Congratulations. This year's French Immersion Award goes to Colin Haskins.
This student consistently participates in class, produces high quality work, and always wants to learn more. She has a keen understanding of the French language and shows a strong interest in the written language and how it works. I strongly encourage Ava to continue with her French learning as she goes to high school next year. Excellent job, Ava, and congratulations on the French Award.
Bonjour, Mrs. McGee and Vejnikas, Bakaj Wanandonjaba. Andishnabamwin, Kinamagekwa, Sir John Moore. First of all, I'd like to express my sincere congratulations to the entire graduating class. My task right now is to award the Ojibwe Language Award for 2020. Ojibwe, of course, is not just a language. It encompasses culture, people, and a way of life. This year's award is presented to two students that have not only met the curriculum expectations, but also have demonstrated a strong commitment to the preservation of the Ojibwe language and culture. It has been an honor to be a part of the journey as each of these young recipients have developed a strong foundation of who they are as Anishinaabekwe. We look forward to seeing and hearing about the impact they continue to have in furthering their understanding of language and culture. It is my honor to present this year's Ojibwe Language Award to Rhianne Smith and Morgan Smith. Nishin, ladies.
The Math Award is given to an individual who demonstrates a talent and interest, but most of all, problem-solving determination in all five strands of math curriculum. As we all know, math can be an intimidating subject, especially with the challenges we face this year. The student is not only determined and hardworking, which is evident to all who know them, but is often found helping others. He is not only seen as a leader to his peers, but as someone they can go to with a question. I would like to say congratulations to this year's Math Award recipient, Colin Haskins.
The recipient of the Geography Award has to demonstrate on a consistent basis a thorough knowledge of geographical facts, terminology, and research, along with being proven to be academically successful in all geography strands. Now, the person who is about to receive this award has proven with hard work and dedication that she was capable and up to the challenge. Her work always seemed to have a special shine to it that showed her talent and quality, such as when she presented a beautifully researched and constructed brochure on why Prince Edward Island would be her perfect place to live. Every aspect of this brochure seemed to be pieced together with care and detail, like it was a special part of her on the page. I am truly honored to have had the opportunity to be her teacher this year. So with that being said, I am happy to present this well-deserved Geography Award to Brianna Trudgeon.
Hi everyone. This year's Science Award is going to someone who has demonstrated great knowledge of science. This person is always participating in science and is often seen helping her peers. This person also has one of the highest overall grades in science this year. Congratulations, Aslan.
In intermediate, history is a subject in which students begin to fully understand the development of their own country, the people, places, events, as well as the difficult decisions. Students begin to realize history is not as clean-cut and unbiased as they originally believed. The recipient of the History Award has listened, read, and questioned the history of Canada, led and engaged in conversation about aspects of its development, and has received the highest overall mark in all history strands. It is my pleasure to present this year's 2020 History Award to Aaliyah Cotton. Congratulations, Aaliyah.
Tonight, I also have the pleasure to present this year's Physical Education and Athlete of the Year Award. This award encompasses not only physical education, but also participation in Sir John Moore extracurricular sports teams, although there have not been many this year. This student embodies the qualities we look for in not only an athlete, but also classmate and leader as well. They show skill, patience, determination, sportsmanship, dedication, and empathy. They are always found participating in all physical education activities, regardless of personal preference. They are always helping others improve, playing by the rules, and being positive role models for other students. I am proud to present this year's Physical Education Award and Athlete of the Year Award to Casey Skouten and Kira Adams.
This year's Art Award is going to someone who has demonstrated knowledge and participation in all areas of the arts this year. This person has also played many lead roles in performances throughout her time here at Sir John Moore. This person also has one of the highest overall marks in all of the art strands this year. Congratulations, Paige.
Working your way through elementary school can be a stressful and fantastic adventure. As you develop as a student, you go through ups and downs, hoping that eventually you come out on top more often than not. The Most Improved Award goes to a recipient who has demonstrated significant improvement in overall academic performance, accepted feedback from teachers, committed to setting goals in multiple areas of student life, and demonstrated a high level of accomplishment towards these goals. I've had the pleasure of teaching this year's recipient in grade 6, as well as in grade 8. He has grown as a student and as a leader. Through chronic disorganization, episodes of humorous chaos, and academic struggles, now into a confident, organized, thoughtful, and academically successful student, I am excited to present this year's award to the most improved student, Landon Allen. Congratulations, Landon.
The recipient of the Citizenship Award has to demonstrate on a daily basis compassion, empathy, and responsibility towards all school members, participate fully in all aspects of school culture, lead by positive example, demonstrate an interest in solving problems with everyday school life, communicate effectively with staff and students, listen to others with care, and demonstrate a high level of reliability and accountability. This is no easy feat. It basically comes down to a simple yet complex question. Who are you as a human being? In answering this question, we can get a full picture of the student that is receiving this award. Are they kind and caring? Do they show respect to others? Are they an active part of their school community? Are they a leader? Would others agree that they exemplify what a true citizen should be? Are they a good person? The recipient of this award would answer these questions with a resounding yes. She is someone whose positivity and outlook on life can affect those around her. And I am truly honored to have had the opportunity to be her teacher this year. So with this being said, I'm happy to present this well-deserved Citizenship Award to Riley Heath.
This particular honor is bestowed upon two students by their peers. They have been recognized as leaders within the division and have been asked to speak on their behalf. It is with pride that we, the staff and students, welcome Colin Haskins and Riley Heath to the stage as this year's valedictorians.
Hello, students, parents, family, and friends. My name is Colin Haskins, and I'm the valedictorian for the Sir John Moore 2020 French class. First up, I want to say thank you to my parents, sister, family, and all the teachers that have helped me to this point. I don't know what I'd do without you. It was 10 years, 9 months ago that we stepped foot in kindergarten for the first time. A lot of us were scared, did not know what to expect. We went with our backpacks that were obviously too big for us, and came out knowing, well, how to draw a stick figure like Waltz. The next few years we remember like it was a blur. Dans mes mémoires, je suis bien, le jour que Madame Kurtz et Mlle McLaughlin ont échangé pour un jour pendant le poisson d'avril, ou quand les garçons ont gagné un tournoi de ballon panier dans 6e année. Right about the time we hit 6th grade, we were older than a lot of the other students, but we still looked up to the grade 8s. We were spending a lot of time trying to fit in with people and friend groups. Then came grade 7. Looking back at it, it did not seem like much, but we were hit with more homework and projects than ever. It was a big year. Finally, this year came. It was our last year of elementary. It went by better than most expected. We learned a lot, picked our classes for high school, and joked around and laughed at each other. Then the coronavirus came along and put the world in this mess. There was a lot of uncertainty and confusion about things we have never done before. And I've seen a lot of things about how 2020 is the worst year ever. But if anything the past has taught me is that challenges improve us. People went into the moon while in threat with itself. Franklin Roosevelt was a president while he was paralyzed from the waist down. Thomas Edison failed 1,000 times before inventing the light bulb. These people overcame adversity and they were pushed and faced with obstacles. I want you to look at this year and use that going forward into high school. We'll use this to become better people. I hope we can safely go back to school and put our best self forward because adversity shows the best of us. Thank you.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We made it. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate each one of you on all of your personal accomplishments throughout elementary school. You should be very proud of yourself. I'm sure that some of us thought that this day would never come, but as my favorite musician would say, just think, most of us have been through 10 years of schooling together. Others have joined along the way. When we first started, we didn't even know how to read, write, or do math. Most of us have grown up together and learned so much about each other. When we look back at our grade 8 year, it has been quite the roller coaster. From field trips to sports to strikes and even pandemics, we've been through it all. In looking back at sports, we weren't able to have the opportunity to do everything, but what our teams did do was awesome. The 7-8 girls team won the championship. The boys 7-8 soccer team came in second. The girls 7-8 volleyball team lost a close game in the finals to take second place. And the boys volleyball team had a great season, losing out in the semifinals. An impressive season all around. Way to go, Knights. I am so happy that we were able to go on our grade 8 trip to Muskoka Woods. I don't know about you, but it was definitely the highlight of my year. Every picture that I was in, I had a huge smile on my face. We will never forget our group dance, getting up on stage in front of all the other schools and making a solid attempt to dancing. And the bus ride. I was worried that it was going to take forever. Long bus rides go much quicker when you're having fun with your friends. We will look back at this field trip and be thankful that we were all able to bond. I have have so many awesome memories from my time at Sir John Moore. In the primary grades, I loved Color House Days and the Terry Fox Run. Being able to run around the school with your friends for a good cause was great. I feel like in grade 3 and 4, I started to come out of my shell and developed some very strong friendships. In grade 6, drama was my favorite subject. I was so excited that my class was going to be sharing a play in the Christmas assembly. I was even happier that I was able to be the one to write the play. Grade 7 was one of my favorite years. This is when we became intermediates. The French and English classes got to work together and got to know each other. I loved going on the trip to the Toronto Raptors game and the Eaton Centre. I felt so independent. Then there was the Point Pelee trip. Oh my goodness, it was so funny when the bus driver took a wrong turn and we ended up getting stuck in the mud in someone's driveway. In grade 8, I had a great time joking around with Mr. Jones and Woltz about football and my crazy obsession with Jimmy Garoppolo. Other than math, gym was also one of my favorite classes. The English and the French students got together in one big class and had so much fun. I will never forget all of these amazing memories at Sir John Moore. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the following people on behalf of the graduates. Thank you to all the teachers, EAs, and staff who have helped in supporting us to getting to where we are today. Thank you to our grade 8 teachers, Ms. Kaur, Mr. Woltz, Mr. Jones, and Ms. Middleton. You always see Ms. Kaur walking the hall to make sure people are on task. You know she's in a good mood when she has a coffee in her hand. Even though Ms. Middleton was only there for a couple months of school, she always put a smile on her students' faces. Mr. Jones had the tough job of coming into a 7-8 class after it already started. Nice job, Mr. Jones. Mr. Woltz will always be remembered for his awesome sense of humor. He has a terrible taste in football teams, but he actually made math fun. A big shout out to Ms. Harrison and Mr. Wise. They are a huge part of making Sir John Moore the great school that it is. Ms. Smith is the fourth principal that we have had since starting at Sir John Moore. We are grateful that she came to our school. In your first year at Sir John Moore, you have done some amazing things. We all appreciate the work that you do. Thank you to Mr. Adam for your dedication for Sir John Moore. Thank you for making our Muskoka Wood trip happen. You will be greatly missed. I would like to thank my friends and fellow classmates for giving me the opportunity to be one of the class valedictorians. I am so honored. It means so much to me. Thank you for helping me to make my time at elementary school so memorable. The fact that I'm making this valedictorian speech is incredible. I would like to personally take this time to thank my family. My dad has sure polished up his math skills, and my mom is my official proofreader. My sister helps me keep on track when I get distracted. I definitely would not be here without their support. I'm the person today because of all the love and support from my family. Who knew that we'd be doing a virtual graduation? Weird, right? Our grade 8 year is definitely not ending like we thought it would. Online learning, Google Meets, our parents as teachers. However, these circumstances have allowed us to grow in many ways. We have become more independent, more organized, and more determined than ever. I believe that all of these skills will help us to a great start in high school. Even though we are going our separate ways to high school, we will always have our time at Sir John Moore to look back at. The friendships we have made, the laughter, and the memories we have created. I believe that our graduating class of Sir John Moore has so much potential. It is just the end of a chapter. Each of us has so much more of our story to write. There are so many possibilities out there for everyone. Even if you don't know exactly what that is yet, you will find it. And lastly, I would like to share a quote. The author is unknown. Whenever you find yourself doubting how far you can go, just remember how far you have come. Remember everything you have faced, all the battles you have won, and all the fears you have overcome. And so, the adventure continues. Thank you.
And I do. silence is a quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Ooh, I'm dead. Bring it to its feet.
Sir John Moore graduates. You made it! What a year it's been! Well, it certainly hasn't been the year that we expected. It will no doubt be the year that we remember, we all remember, forever. In fact, if you think about it, your grade 8 year is literally going down in history. I want you to stop and think about that for a minute. It's easy to get caught up in what could have been and what you missed out on in your graduating year. But I'd like to take a moment to flip the focus from what you've lost to what you've gained. You've gained a new appreciation for the school system and what it means for you and to you. The interactions with your peers, the support of your teachers, the daily routine of coming to your school community means so much more to you now than it did before. And I want you to remember that as you get into your high school in the fall. You've also, many of you have shown resilience. You've shown responsibility, organization, and a desire to learn and ability to adapt. And for some of you, you didn't know that this was there, that it existed within you. And it's through this experience where you've been forced to dig deep and find these skills that you've really grown and flourished. And these are essential skills, not just for high school, but for life. You've also gained an appreciation for the fragility of life and how we all need to do our part to keep others safe. We have sacrificed connection and socialization for the benefit of our community and the more vulnerable populations. This has been a lesson in humanity for all of us. We are a small piece of a greater puzzle,
And while our sacrifices were difficult, and you may not even fully comprehend their impact, but please know that your efforts throughout the school closures have impacted many lives in very profound ways. Lastly, you've gained notoriety. There has never been a time in history that I can think of where the school system closed their physical buildings and implemented emergency orders telling people, requiring people to quarantine in their homes. This is a story that you will tell your children and your grandchildren for years to come. Gone are the days of the story of the walking uphill both ways to school. And when I was a child, my phone had a cord. Your graduating year is marked on the calendar and preserved for all of time in history. And I want you to remember these things that we've gained as you reflect on your remote learning and move forward into your secondary careers. And I sincerely hope that you really take the time to reflect on what worked and didn't work for you as a learner. If you've struggled with the learning, then ask yourself why and what would you need to have to be successful. Make a plan and reach out to people to support you in September in high school. And if you've embraced the remote learning and really excelled, I want you to think about what did you do that helped you be successful? How did you stay organized and how did you stay focused? Because these are important things that you will need to bring with you with all of your courses in secondary and beyond. High school is an amazing time in your life where you are transitioning into young adults who are actively working towards your hopes and dreams and goals in life. But it can also be a difficult time where you become uncertain of who you are and you struggle to figure out where you fit in this world. It's a time of independence and learning both the negative and the positive consequences of your actions. And I want you to remember, if you encounter difficult times, think back to now and what we've gone through. And I want to impress the importance of stopping and remembering these few months, because you are important, you are resilient, you are valued, and you are adaptable. You have got this. You can get through anything. And with that, I'd like to say thank you. Thank you to our families for all of their support of your children, of our educators. We could not have finished this year without you. And our appreciation is just saying thank you is not enough. Thank you to our communities for rallying together to support our youth. Thank you to our educators for your flexibility, for your adaptability, and for your availability to our grade eights. It was not easy, but you did it, and it is appreciated. Thank you to Mr. Adam for your tech support, and thank you to Mrs. Harrison for all of the hard work that she put into your virtual yearbook, but also this very presentation. And lastly, thank you to you, the graduates, our students, for asking questions, for advocating for what you need and what you want to see, for remaining positive, and for continuing to work hard right until the very end. Be proud. And to conclude our graduation ceremony, I would like to say it one more time. Go Knights! Thank you, and be proud.